called Fractal. My friends, I have a confession to make. You see, just 2 days ago, I was thirsty for fame. I wanted to be the female Gandhi of the 21st century. I wanted to be the princess of peace. I wanted to be a Martin Luther queen. I wanted to be great, you see. I wanted to save the world. I wanted to soar across the land, scooping up hungry children by the thousands with my infinite wings and bring them to my nest to feast on food I prepared for them with my very own hands. I wanted to be the greatest hero the world had ever seen. In fact, just 2 days ago, I swore that I would settle for nothing less. And so, needless to say, when only 3 people came to my open space in room C for a prayer for peace, I was a little disappointed. Because before I got on the plane, I imagined it would be hundreds. But as the 4 of us women prayed in a circle together, I began to feel something developing in my heart. "Shh," it said, "God is trying to teach you something." So we prayed and we sang, and we prayed and we sang, and we traveled up and out into the stars. And then, in the middle of the song, I could clearly see the whole world spinning inside of this circle of ours. And something whispered, "You are saving the world right now." A heavy burden was suddenly lifted from my shoulders, and I knew that God's grace was working through us. And later, I had an opportunity to ask the one, the only Charles Eisenstein, a single question. And so I asked my hero, "Who is your greatest inspiration, Charles?" And he replied simply, "I cannot rank inspiration the way that economists rank the value of people and things. But I can tell you this. There was once a woman who spent 15 years caring for her daughter, who was completely paralyzed in a car crash. For 15 years, she fed her, washed her body, and turned her over in her bed to prevent bed sores. And after 15 years of this work, without ever saying a single word to her mother, for she could not speak after the crash, the daughter finally died. This mother, this is who inspires me," he said. Later, the director of the Red Cross Museum explained to us all, "We are an organization of 12,000 employees and 13 million volunteers. But at the end of the day, it is about one human being helping another human being. This is what is important about humanitarian aid." And so at this point, God is no longer whispering. No, God is shouting for me to wake up to the fact that no act of love is greater or less than another. And I am changing. After these events, I asked myself, who is the greater person? Mahatma Gandhi or the woman who spent 15 years caring for her invalid daughter and then dies, nameless? And the answer arose in my heart and roared through my mind and said, they are both equally important, precious, and beautiful people, and each of their jobs are essential to the sheer wonder of this universe. And an angel came and whispered in my mind and said this: God has ears that hear the cry of a fly that is stuck in a cup of water on the kitchen table. God has ears that hear the gunshots and bomb blasts of a civil war in a country on a continent between the oceans of a planet that spins around a star that shines like an ember in the spiraling galaxy of your eyes. God has ears that hear the thundering applause that is built of the nuts and bolts of slaps and claps of people who adore the way piano keys and strings sing beneath the fingertips of a man named Amadeus, a man named Stevie Wonder, a man named Elton John. And God heard it the moment your heartbeat was born, deep in the belly of a woman you call mom. And suddenly I realized that my mom and Elton John are mothers of the same song. And I cry out to this angel, can I too carry this love inside of me? Can I too carry this love in my heart? A love that not only works for peace on earth, but also for peace within and peace directly between me and you and all beings. A love that sits patiently and folds red pieces of paper into the shape of cranes for a sick woman next door. Can I too have ears that hear the cry of a fly trapped in a glass of tap water? Ears that hear the cry of each star in the sky, thousands of them begging for someone to just come and watch them shine. For too long I have compared and ranked acts of love as either great or trivial. For too long I have silenced the woman in my mind who cries for more music, more joy, more beauty, as if I have more important work to do than dance in the streets and save my own world. For too long I have passed the woman begging on the street because I was too busy becoming the princess of peace. Yes, replies the angel, you too can have this love. And so I walked outside the conference building, and suddenly I could see the galaxy spinning inside of the eyes of a young boy. He fell hard against the pavement and began to cry. I ran to his side and held him in my arms like a mother holds her child, and I knew that he represented the entire universe. I knew that in that moment I was holding the whole world in my arms. Who knew that enough love for all of humanity could fit in these little hearts of ours? Who knew it could fit inside of a single teardrop that falls from your eye? Well, now I know. Whether I'm the next Martin Luther King, or I simply sing a song of hope to an audience of one and then die, I will be happy with my life. For on an infinite continuum, all worlds are of equal size and worth. And in God's eyes, all worlds are equally significant. Whether it is the world we see in pictures taken from outer space, or the world that is seen by a child's eyes, whether this is a world documented on the nightly news, or the world that lies within an Eloise flower on the hillside, or anything in between. Now I feel that no task is too small, and no task is too large for the incredible soul that each of you are. And I'm happy to say that the thirst for fame I carried into this conference, like a burden on my back, has evaporated. All that remains is an inner peace imbued with a golden hue of profound gratitude to you all. Now I realize that this is not some random group of people in some random city, in some random world. No. I see now that I'm sitting amongst entire worlds of their own. I'm sitting amongst kings and queens, princesses and princes of peace in their own right. Beautiful mothers and fathers, sons and daughters, with fiery hearths of passion residing within. There is no poem I could write, no sequence of words that could ever explain the beauty I see in each of you. So thank you all, truly and deeply, from the bottom of my heart, for all the ways in which you each save the world.
Thank you so much. AJ wants to take a picture with you. All right. In the meantime, before we have some closing announcements,